original Ford Figo was launched back in 2010. And in the 5 years that it's been with us, it has seen one facelift and about 3 lakh units sold, which is not bad considering that it goes up against the likes of the extremely popular Maruti Swift. Well, now it's 2015 and we have with us the brand new Ford Figo. Now, usually companies launch their hatchbacks first and then make a compact sedan based on that hatchback. But Ford has gone the other way around. They launched the sub 4-meter Aspire sedan a little while back, and now we've got its hatchback version right here as the new Figo. It's basically the Aspire sedan sans boot. Now, we already love the Aspire quite a lot. So does its hatchback sibling inspire as much love? Well, time to find that out.
In the current crop of compact sedans, the Aspire stands out as the handsome one. And since the Figo retains pretty much the same shape up to the C-pillar, it goes without saying that this hatch is a looker as well, one of the best in this class of car. In fact, the hatch at the back gels a lot better than the boot with Ford's new design language. And our test cars, painted in a rather attractive shade of orange, also showed immaculate paint finish and exuded a sense of being extremely well put together. This attention to detail makes the new Figo a rather inviting proposition to potential buyers just by itself.
Well, the interior of this new Ford Figo is definitely a very familiar place. Well, that's because it's nearly identical to what you find in the Figo Aspire, and we've been driving the Aspire quite a lot. Now, of course, this is not a bad thing at all, because I think this whole new design theme is definitely one of Ford's best, and it's a marked improvement over what you found on the old Ford Figo. In fact, it's pretty much common amongst all new Ford cars now. It started off with the EcoSport, came onto the Aspire, and now onto this Figo. What I like about the interior, apart from the design, is also the fit and finish. Everything is put together quite well. It's quite solid. I wouldn't say it's, you know, premium in terms of the plastic feel. It's just about there. But overall, fit and finish is definitely top notch. Something that's really cool about this Figo hatchback is just the sheer amount of space that you have in here. I mean, I'm sitting up in the front and I'm very comfortable. The seat itself is quite comfortable. I love the steering wheel, the way you can, you know, just grip it. There's plenty of room at the back as well. Now, even when I have the seat in my driving position, there's plenty of knee room in the back for even someone as large as me to sit fairly comfortably. And that's pretty much saying something in terms of, you know, just how well Ford has been able to package this new car and how well it has translated into a hatchback as well as a sedan. And even though this might be a hatchback, it doesn't really lose out too much in terms of its boot space. 257 liters, which is, well, not class leading, but definitely not bad for this class of car. Now, it also comes loaded with quite a few features. The variant I'm driving is the one below top, the Titanium, not the Titanium Plus, and it doesn't get for my sync, but it gets something very interesting called My Dock. Now, this lets you pretty much sort of plug in your phone and sort of place it in the center of the car. It acts like a multimedia screen for your car, and it can pretty much fit phones of any size right there, and then plug into either USB or auxiliary and whatever you prefer. Now, this model doesn't get Ford MyKey either. It's only there on the top end variant. Now, that's a lovely feature to have. What it allows you to have is two keys, one master key and sort of one junior key. And you can program the car to not go beyond a certain speed limit, to not have the volume for the audio beyond a certain limit if you're using the junior key. So if you hand that key to your kids well, you can ensure that they don't drive beyond a certain speed limit and keep the volume of the audio at a reasonable level. So I think it's a very cool feature to have, and well, this segment hasn't seen anything like that ever.
Ford offers three engine options in this new Figo. A brand new 1.2-liter petrol motor pumping out 88 PS of power and 112 Nm of torque. A 1.5-liter diesel with 100 PS and 250 Nm, and a 1.5-liter petrol that makes 112 PS and 136 Nm, which is only available in one trim level with a 6-speed dual clutch automatic gearbox. Now for the drive, we only had the 1.5-liter petrol automatic and the 1.5-liter diesel available, and let me say right off the bat that both of them were rather impressive.
Now in terms of the way it drives, well, the one I'm driving right now is the 1.5-liter petrol automatic, 112 PS on tap. The motor is quite responsive and the gearbox itself is quite good. It's a dual clutch gearbox. It's one of the cheapest dual clutch gearboxes in the world, and well, it really performs fairly well. I mean, don't expect lightning quick shifts like an Audi R8 or something, but it does shift reasonably fast for a car of this segment. You can drive it comfortably when you put it in D and just go along, or if you want a bit of sort of action, you can put the gearbox down in sport mode and then you can change gears manually using these two little buttons on the gear shifter here. It's a slightly strange experience to use these up and down sort of buttons. It almost makes it feel like a video game of sorts. I kind of prefer Tiptronics if you ask me, but well, it's definitely not bad for the segment, and well, it is responsive, that's for sure. Now don't expect the automatic to give you great mileage figures. It is sort of reasonable in that department. Ford claims 17 kilometers per liter. Well, I think you can expect realistically about 13 to 14 kmpl, which I mean some might say is not too bad at all. What is really the most efficient thing that Ford has is the 1.5 diesel, and well, that one, Ford claims about 25 kmpl on that. We were cruising down the highway at 80-90 in that car and it was showing 25 kmpl on the dashboard right there, which is definitely very impressive. Of course, that figure might not be altogether exact. We'll get the exact figures and we get the car for a full road test, but it's an indication of just how efficient that car is. And of course, it comes in the manual, which means it's a lot more fun to drive, and that diesel is just beautiful. It has lots of torque in any gear. You can just pretty much pull at any speed, even in fifth gear.
This diesel motor is certainly one of Ford's best, a massive improvement over the 1.4 Duratorque mill from the last generation Figo. And I would even go as far as to say that this is the best diesel motor in this class of cars.
When it comes to ride quality, well, it is a little bit on the stiffer side, but though it's not bone jarring if you take it over bumps or through potholes, and I think it's very typical of Ford cars. They let you feel what's going on the road, and of course that's done to give you a much better handling package, which this Figo definitely has. Even the old Figo was a good handling car, but it was let down by its choice of engines. Now this car has two great engines right here, the 1.5 petrol and the 1.5 diesel, which give it that much needed punch, which complement the car's wonderful handling characteristics. And of course, well, we're driving it on straight roads here in Noida. Hopefully when we get the car in Pune, we will put it through a bit of twisties and find out just how well it handles. But I am certain it's going to do quite well in that department. Now that was a quick preview of the Ford Figo hatchback. It's available in a total of 13 variants, 6 with a 1.2-liter petrol motor, 6 with a 1.5-liter diesel, and 1 with a 1.5-liter petrol automatic. Pricing for the same starts at ₹4,30,000 for the base petrol, going all the way up to ₹6,91,000 for the automatic petrol 1.5. The diesel is 1 lakh rupees more expensive than the petrol, starting at ₹5,30,000, ending at the top end at ₹7,40,000 ex showroom deli. Now sadly, the diesel isn't available in the automatic version. Now if you had to choose between the Figos, if you want convenience and if you want refinement, well, you can't do better than that petrol motor with the automatic gearbox. But if you want a fun to drive experience and if you want crazy mileage, well, that diesel is the choice of car to buy. Now sadly, we haven't tested the 1.2-liter engine here yet. That's something that's reserved for the full road test when we do it back in Pune. Well, of course, it's a great car, but if you're looking for reasons to pick one up, here are five good ones. Well, firstly, the way it looks. It's a fantastic looking car. I think it's the best looking hatchback in the market right now. And when you talk about its fit and finish, well, it's really a notch above everything else in the segment. And then the space inside, it's got plenty of room, enough for five adults, one of the best in its class for certain. And when it comes to gizmos, the Ford is absolutely loaded. It comes with the MyKey, the MySync, it's pretty much spec'd up like crazy. And one aspect, safety, which is often ignored by most manufacturers, well, Ford has that in spades as well. Even the base variant of the car gets one driver side airbag. From the second variant onwards, they get at least two airbags, with the top end car getting a total of six airbags. Now, finally, I can say this about the Figo. I want one.